Top 10 cool things you didn't know about the Roadster. Starting off with acceleration. This car can accelerate from 0 to 60 in about 1.9 seconds. This car has been unveiled since 2017, and since then, Tesla has actually released a plaid model that will actually be coming out in the near future. And that will do 0 to 60 in less than 1.99 seconds. Those are nearly the specs of the Roadster, and what we can infer from that is that the Roadster will actually be even quicker. So how does this car achieve this acceleration figure? It's because of a big battery, and that also helps in the range category. This car has about 620 miles of range, or about 1,000 kilometers of range, the longest range of any electric vehicle that supposedly will actually come out in the near future. 1,000 kilometers of range is so much that even gas cars struggle to get this range. And this range is actually highway range, which means at highway speeds, you'll actually get 620 miles or about 1,000 kilometers of range on this vehicle. Electric vehicles tend to have a lower range on the highway compared to city driving, so we can actually expect 700 plus miles of city range if we're going to talk about it like that. So the battery pack of this vehicle is extremely heavy. So how will this car handle on the track or just in normal everyday driving? Well, because the battery is actually below the floor of the car, this car actually has a very, very low center of gravity compared to pretty much most other supercars. And supercars in general have a very low center of gravity. They want to get their engine really low and just have the really good cornering force. And that will actually make the car handle like it's on rails. We also have to consider this is going to be Tesla's first supercar, like a proper supercar that does something that has never been done before, especially at this amount of performance level. And because you can't actually beat physics, batteries do weigh a lot, and they're going with a different route. They're actually going to use cold gas thrusters. Now, if you want me to make a video explaining cold gas thrusters, why are they called cold gas thrusters in the first place and how do they work and everything, just let me know in the comments down below. So cold gas thrusters are basically just compressed air. And so what Tesla's planning to do with this is to actually fire them out, but shoot the air out at extreme velocity, and that will actually propel the vehicle forward. It's just Newton's third law. Every reaction has an opposite and equal reaction. And so this can actually bring the 0 to 60 time of the vehicle even lower. Some people are speculating it could be down to 1.1 seconds. So Elon is saying that the Roadster will actually have 10 cold gas thruster nozzles seamlessly blending into the design of the car. And what that's going to mean is that you're going to have extreme cornering forces, because when you're actually taking a corner, tires only have so much grip. When you have this basically thrust nozzle, it's going to actually shoot out thrust in the opposite direction you're actually going to go, and that's going to push the car in the direction you want the car to actually turn. So the cold gas thrusters will allow you to actually corner at immense rates, because now you're not limited by the traction of the tires. Instead, you are limited by how much force these thrusters can output. So what that's going to mean is that even a heavy vehicle like the Roadster, it's going to corner like it's a rocket. Because this car is going to accelerate really, really quickly, you're actually going to need to stop really, really quickly as well. So I'm guessing that they're actually going to plan to use some braking forces using these thrusters, so you can actually stop much, much quicker than what your disc brakes allow. Now, these tanks are actually going to be present in the interior of the vehicle. They're actually going to take up the interior space, but not the front two seats. The front two seats are going to remain pretty spacious as they are right now. They're actually going to take up the rear seats, which were actually meant for smaller people.
So it's a 2+2, 2+2. Okay, you can't put giant people in the rear seat, but you will put, okay, a giant person squashed or a small person fit in the back.
And so that's going to mean that this Roadster is only going to be a two-seater instead of a 2+2. And while on the topic of the interior is extremely different from every other car that Tesla actually has. Tesla just updated their new Model S and X vehicles, and you can see that they have a horizontal display and obviously an instrument cluster right in front of the driver, just like every other car on the road. So this Roadster is going to have a tiny little screen behind the steering wheel showing you exactly what you need to see, like speed and such. But instead of having a horizontal screen like all the other Tesla models, it's going to have a vertical screen. And we don't know if this is going to be updated, maybe support a horizontal screen in the future. We just know that so far in the concept vehicle, it's a horizontal screen, and hopefully it works out well, because this is going to be a car that you're going to drive, and you're going to drive it a lot. And the interior overall looks pretty spacious. It's not that crammed. It looks a lot more spacious than other vehicles, a lot more spacious than other supercars in general. And so you're likely going to spend quite a bit of time in the interior, and because it has such a long range, you might want to take some road trips. And because it has a massive battery, it'll actually charge really, really quickly. And that brings me on to my next point, charging speed. Now, charging this vehicle is going to be extremely quick. Right now, Tesla only has superchargers that supply up to 250 kilowatts, and I have my doubts that those superchargers are actually locked or software locked, and that they can actually output more like 350 kilowatts in the future. So when vehicles like the Tesla Roadster, the Cybertruck, or the Plaid Plus Model S, when those come online, those have insane ranges. Cybertruck and Model S will have a 500 plus mile range. Roadster will have a 600 plus mile range, and likely they'll have really big battery packs. And for those battery packs, you want really quick charging. So if you can get 350 kilowatts of charging or even higher, that's gonna actually make your road trips just that much easier because it'll charge up much quicker. You can get like 400 miles of range in about 20 minutes. And because you're on the road trip, you might actually wanna carry some luggage, say a backpack or just proper suitcases. And because the Roadster has a battery and it doesn't have an engine at the back or the front, it actually has quite a fair amount of room, like enough to actually put your stuff in and actually go places. The reason why regular supercars don't is because they have a massive engine, like a V10, V8, or even V12 engines. And because those engines are really, really big, you actually need a lot of space. So they take up pretty much your entire trunk space. But with the Roadster, because the battery is actually at the bottom and the motors will actually, you know, they're actually quite small. If you think about it, they're about the size of a watermelon. You actually got tons of room to put your stuff in and actually carry other passengers like children. So you can actually take a family road trip in this vehicle. And although it might be uncomfortable because it's a sports car, basically a supercar, the point is you can actually do it and it'll cost you very little in maintenance. Because this is an electric car, and electric cars, as we all know, basically don't require that much maintenance at all. Actually, the battery and motor basically require zero maintenance at all. It's gonna be all the other factors, like your tires. Your tires are likely gonna wear out much quicker with this vehicle because you're gonna wanna stomp on it quite often, and that's gonna wear your tires out really, really quickly. But other than that, unless you opt for the SpaceX package, which includes the cold gas thrusters, there really isn't that much to maintain on this vehicle. And with a regular supercar, it's extremely expensive to maintain that vehicle because there's always something going wrong with it. You have to actually take it into service every few months or a year. But with this Tesla Roadster, you're not gonna have to do that. Because it's electric, you can actually drive this thing as much as you want because it'll have like a 2 million mile lifespan on its drivetrain. And if you know anything about supercars, you definitely know that normal cars rarely ever last to even 100,000 miles, let alone 2 million. It's gonna be really cheap to own. And actually, if you consider the value proposition of this vehicle and compare the price of this, especially its specs compared to all other vehicles, this is really, really cheap, like really cheap. It's probably 1/10 the cost of all the other petrol vehicles that actually achieve anywhere near the performance levels that this is promising. Now add in a SpaceX package with the cold gas thrusters and there is just no competition. There's no other vehicle that can even come close. You're getting the fastest car on the road, the fastest production car on the road, and you're legally allowed to drive it. It's insane the value that you're actually getting with this vehicle. Now I want to come to my final point, which is full self-driving. If you thought all of that was really impressive, especially price to performance, think about this. This car will be able to drive itself. Literally. And this is why I reserved this point to the end, because this is going to be like the only supercar in the world that will actually be able to drive itself. So why is this important? Well, FSD is actually going to change the entire world. Full self-driving cars are here and they're coming, and they're coming really, really fast. And basically in no time, everyone's going to have a full self-driving car. Think about it. You can actually give this car to your son or daughter and they can actually just go to school and the car could just literally drop them off and pick them up. And you don't have to worry, you can be out at work or anything. And this works for all Tesla vehicles, not just the Roadster. It just works for every single Tesla made after 2016. And this is something that's gonna be very special to those people. Now, I don't think this is gonna be a big deal to people who are actually interested in buying the Tesla Roadster, because obviously it's a driver's car, so you wanna drive it. But just having that aspect of having full self-driving so that if you're stuck in traffic or just in general, you could just let the car do whatever you want or whatever it wants and just take you to your destination and come back and whatever. It's just going to be something that's really, really convenient that people don't realize yet. But once they realize that this is possible, no one's going to want to go back to regular cars that are not full self-driving. And this is going to change the entire industry. And that's why I keep bringing this up, because it's such an important factor. So there you go. Top 10 things you probably didn't know. You probably knew a lot of them, especially if you're following the Tesla Roadster and just Elon in general, and about what he's actually talked about. You probably knew almost all of them, actually. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this one, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Peace.